Welcome. In this chapter, we'll talk about July 2019 edition for Kurukshetra, which talks about the rural non-farm sector. Now, in the rural sector, we already know agriculture is considered to be a mainstay economy. But what besides agriculture? What are the other non-farm activities that could be brought in? So, it could be manufacturing, it could be mining, it could be small-scale industries that could be seen, medium and small-scale industries that could be seen. Also, we have construction activities that are there. Minegra scheme through which you have rural employment, 100 days of minimum guarantee program are important. Food processing is one of the major industries. And then yes, you have tourism, rural tourism is important, handicrafts as one of the important industries. So here are some of the very important case studies for handicrafts that could be seen. So in Gujarat, we have bandis. In Assam, we have bamboo craft. In Tamil Nadu, you have Thanjavur paintings, Madhubani art and Sujni art from Bihar. So those are some of the important local arts that are seen in the rural areas for handicrafts. So when I say non-farm sector, handicrafts, handloom activities, textile industries are important. Over the years, we have seen that the jobs in the agriculture have been decreasing significantly. So what we need to give thrust on is the non-farm sector. So non-farm sector could be in the form of mining activities, construction and manufacturing activities that could be seen in. So Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Scheme that talks about 100 days of guaranteed employment. You have Deendayal, Upadhyay, Grameen, Kaushal Yojana, which talks about developing skill and productive capacity. Deendayal, Antyodaya Yojana, which talks about rural livelihood mission, providing affinity to the women self-help groups, talking about the reach to the poor for the local level. You have the Aajeevika Grameen Express Yojana, which talks about rural transportation to be developed to connect it better to the market, education facilities, hospitals, healthcare, promoting rural tourism through the developmental activities. And this all can be brought about through the JAM Trinity, that is the Jandan, Aadhaar and Mobile. You have numerous regulations that have come up for the small scale sectors. Talking about the initial capital investment, so government can take care of that. The initial capital investment can be taken into consideration. We have transport storage communication systems, finance, insurance, real estate businesses that could be seen, community social personal schemes that could be seen in, and micro small scale enterprises, that is the MSME Act that has taken into consideration, which is important. Also, there are residual sector hypothesis, which has seen a significant growth in the employment in the non-farm activities. Now, this was given by Vaidyanathan. So this is a very good case study that you can bring in into your examination. The residual sector hypothesis, which talks about the labor absorptive capacity of an agricultural region, which is now limited. So what is a trend is towards a non-farm activity. So understanding how non-farm labors could be developed, what are the incentives that could be brought about, what is the growth formulation and the skill development that is required. So 1/5 of the rural household work with self-employment, mainly in the agricultural sector, and therefore they are below poverty line in most of the cases. So what we need to bring in is more employment opportunities, migration of people from urban areas to rural areas, bringing in good lucrative jobs into rural areas, and coping with the farmers failing with the local crops. So tourism is something that could be given a thrust. We have already covered rural tourism in one of the separate lectures of Kurukshetra previously. So you have various rural circuit development that has taken place under the circuit development or Swadesh Darshan schemes. There are three different categories under which we define region. It could be a geographical region based on a specific climate characteristic. It could be based on rural culture, or it could be based on the practices of sowing and harvesting. Similarly, there are numerous ecotourism practices. So some of those are important. You have the Purushwadi village in Maharashtra, Kalp village in Uttarakhand. You have the regions in Gujarat, the tribal trails in Rajasthan, the stone craft of Odisha. Those are some of the very good examples that we have seen. Also farm produce, agrotourism is important. Mangoes from Ratnagiri in Maharashtra, vineyards in Nasik have been a center of attraction for a lot of of tourists, you have the local food processing industries. Visit to those factories have been one of the major economy stays for these regions. Also, we are trying to bring in more capacity building. Hodka village has always been a very good example across your Kurukshetra and Yojana for most of the cases. So that's something that you can cite for your case studies definitely. We have numerous marketing strategies which has come up. So bringing in the traditional craft, handloom and handicraft to the common people through marketing, through advertisement, or through approaching to the common people of the urban areas is one of the important strategies. Then we also focus on the non-seasonal and the supplementary employment which can be provided to small marginal farmers during the lean period. So during the lean period, they can shift to the non-farm activities. When the season is there for agriculture, they can switch to the agricultural crops. So those activities could be related to agriculture. It could be related to food processing. So Skill India campaign launched in 2015 was an idea to it. Then you have Skill Development Mission, National Skill Qualification Framework, Kaushal Vikas Yojana are some of the efforts to it. Bringing in more skill, more specialization, eradication of poverty, role of NGOs is very, very important. Then we also have private sector which has been providing training, community service centers which are working in line with the NGOs and the private sector. The corporate social responsibility has been important. Then Deendayal, Antyodaya Yojana, the National Rural Livelihood Mission, is important to elevate the poverty, to bring in community institutions for the development of poor. So you have 2 lakh self-help groups that have been working under this chain. The idea is to move from poverty to prosperity, and that's through the various schemes. So Parikarma has been a very good case study. So she has been working through one of the self-help groups which is known as Vasundhara, and through her journey she has brought in loans for the members at a rate of 24% interest, and then she has started meeting the small consumption requirements. The various loans have been availed at the district level. Also, government has invested a lot of money, and now old age security has been given to most of the people involved with her. Similarly, handloom and handicraft has been one of the major industries in India. You have more than 43 lakh weavers which are associated directly and indirectly, of which 77% are women employees. So these arts, the local tradition should be given a thrust. The National Handloom Development Board is important to develop the handloom sector in India. Also to give it a worldwide recognition. So loans are provided at a concessional rate of 6% for the first 3 years. You have Deendayal Upadhyay Hastkala Sankul that is established in Varanasi, which is for the promotion of handloom industry and handicraft industry. Similarly, you have the development of handloom mark. So Indian Institute of Handloom Technologies have come up. Where are they located is important. So this is again a very important question, not for your mains, but for your prelims. But for your mains, you can give your case studies that you have institutions like Indian Institute of Handloom Technology coming up to promote the handloom craft. You have National Handloom Development Program, which has come up with a comprehensive cluster development approach. Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana, which is again a kind of scheme to give a thrust to the handloom sector. Similarly, food processing is another important sector. It contributes to nearly 14% of the GDP and 13% of the food exports from India. So food processing is aimed to bring in sustainability, bring in crop diversification, commercialization, reduce the wastage that is there, improve the shelf life and value addition. So this has been made possible through the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sampada Yojana, integrated cold chain, value storage, value addition infrastructure, food safety regulation that has come up. Also, there are challenges that have to be seen and met in future. So that's important. Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen, that's a mission which focuses on clean India. It has been working significantly to make India open defecation free by 2nd October 2019, and that's the target coming very soon. So we have a lot of funding seen to from the non-governmental agencies and corporate sectors to fund the Swachh Bharat Mission. Similarly, we are trying to integrate it with the socio-economic impact, bringing in behavioral change in the habit of people working on the issues of sanitation, bringing in much more sustainability that could be seen. Also, Northeast has been one of the focuses. So some of the fruits are very specific to the local areas of Northeast. For example, Sofi in Meghalaya is a fruit during the spring season which welcomes the spring in Meghalaya. Similarly, you have other fruits which are Sohingon, Sofo Khasi, Sofsang. So those are different varieties of fruits that are locally seen in the Northeast, highly perishable. Local variety could be developed, and Meghalaya is the state which has the highest tribal base with Garo Khasi Jayantia Hill and Khasi tribe in the Khasi Hills, where you have most of these vegetation that could be seen. Also, to give this a thrust, you have Meghalaya startup policy that started in 2018 to bring a thrust to this. Local hearts have been established, local development works have come up, exhibitions have come up. You have spices, pickles being sold, bamboo arts being sold, and more of the women are being employed as a part of self-help groups to encourage this. Local entrepreneurs have been developed. So those are some of the important developments that we have seen here. We'll be bringing in many more editions of Yojana Kurukshetra Down to Earth with you. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.